Yo, so Tcsm has released the upcoming outfit packs for the victims and family members. So let's talk about these fits/7 recolors to look forward to and if they're worth the $4.99. Yes, $4.99. These do not cost no $10. So if your panties were in a bunch about that, we'll unravel them, cause that 10 is probably for something else. The first pack they released was Connie. Going from left to right, we have Connie's first look from her Sheen lookbook. The white shirt, orange shorts, and yellow headband/bandana thing. Off top, this is one of my favorites in her pack, and I can say I almost definitely rock this one. I love how the color correlates and gives her a fresh look. Next is the yellow strawberry shirt with the blue shorts combo. Okay, the strawberry is cute, and so are the blue shorts, but for me, the gray sleeves are throwing it off a bit. I'm not a fan of this combo. Next is the purple/maroon situation. I like this shirt and headband, but not the shorts so much. Assuming these are shorts because, well, it's Connie. But the next fit has me thinking these may be jeans, because I think Connie's shorts are short AF, so this pink strawberry situation will look dope as some pants, not gonna lie. I like this one, but the blue was kind of rubbing me the wrong way at first, but the more I look at it, the more I like it. Next is her Sunny D orange shirt, and I say this is a solid fit for sure. Again, these are just my opinions. Be sure to share yours in the comments as well. We all have different tastes, fam. Now we have my favorite from her pack. Ooh-wee! This cream color with the red/maroon situation is so freaking perfect, and the one I will definitely have my Connie rocking. So yeah, that means I'm getting these. Last, we have her black sunflower shirt. This isn't bad, I just wish she had some black shorts to rock. I know everything doesn't have to be matchy-matchy, but black would have ate. Or even some white shorts or pants, you feel me? I rate this pack an 8. Next we have the man with the plan, the Mr. See It All, the goat throat, the last one pig but the first one to dip, my favorite, Sunny. Was that glaze too much? Oh the f well. I love him and I'ma stick beside him. Let's just say they got my boy right. All his looks look good AF, from front to back to left to right, up and down and inside out, but starting at the orange and black situation. His first showcase fit has him in Halloween themed colors. Like if that's not love, I don't know what is. What I will say before moving on is that it will be great to have different hairstyles for the characters down the line. Next we have his blue diamond striped Louis shirt with the white tank underneath. Being that blue is my favorite color, this would be the fit I would probably rock first, no cap. Next we can see him in the green Gucci pattern button down, again in a white tank. Let's not forget the S on his chest, I mean neck, for his name Sunny. And ooh wee, this white button down gonna make me act up for real, but I'ma chill. Once we make it to the white button down, we see that he'll also have on wristbands with these outfits. I don't care for the wristbands, it could have been a different watch or even a bracelet for real. Next we have another Sunny situation with the yellow Guess button down paired with the Abercrombie & Fitch striped tank and a purple wristband. I like the yellow because it complements his skin so well. Next we have this Mac Daddy Brown situation with the yellow wristband. This one's cool but not my fave. And last he got that Big Daddy Knickknack Paddywhack black button down with the maroon tank. I'ma for sure be wearing this one. This fit will also be good for blending in. I'll rate this pack a 10. Next up we got my girl Julie with the big old booty. Believe it or not, this is my second main to play as, cause she's a runner, she's a track star. Starting from left to right, we got her in the black flower printed Fashion Nova fit. Let me tell you something, I didn't look at this long enough the first time, cause now I know I'ma definitely have these cheeks clap. I mean, have her running away, bobbing and weaving from the family in this. The jewelry cool too. I like the added messed up makeup touch, cause Julie be so over being trapped and she gonna let it be known she don't wanna be near none of these MFs. Next, she's rocking her late night maroon Savage Fenty 2 piece with the back out. Call him as Jay if you're nasty. Let me stop. Next, she's pulling up in another Fashion Nova flower printed 2 piece in the color of orange with a hint of yellow flowers all over. This can definitely be her Halloween fit. I ain't mad at it. After that, we got her Woman of the Night / Street Walker Savage Fenty fit. At first glance, it appears to be all black, but on the side of her chest assist, you can see some purple accents. Also revealed in this fit are bracelets. Now she better not be in the basement changalanga bringing the attention to her. She already get attention because of that gyah, but I doubt they'll make the bracelets loud. But imagine though. Alright, next she has a yellow flower printed Fashion Nova fit. Bright as hell, so she'll be worn during the day, unless you're trying to stand out at the parties. Next, she's rocking her two-piece denim fit from Sheen, and the material looks nice. I definitely rock this one on my girl. Last we have a teal/blue/green Fashion Nova flower fit. It's straight, but the first two, the black and the jean, are my fave from this pack. I'll rate this pack an 8. Alright, now we got Mr. Leland, Mr. Stick'em Down, Mr. I'm with Anna but I love Julie. Papa was a rolling stone but come roll over here since you on tour, Leland. I need to chill. Okay, so first up we have him in the burnt orange denim jacket from Guess 1970s fall collection, paired with the white button down underneath, showing a little bit but not too much skin. Hair is on Justin Bieber baby in the front and Billy Ray Cyrus in the back. If that's a some mole on his face. I like it. Come on, Beauty Mark. This fit is cool, and I think it would be considered his Halloween fit. Next, he's rocking Guess's navy blue wash denim with the gray button down. They definitely kept my boy in the Guess fall catalog because he's seen in another light blue denim jacket with beige accents on the pockets, collar, and wrist. So far, I'm loving the light blue the most. Next, we have him in the Can I Buy You a Drink denim with the patterned Gucci maroon button down underneath. You can give me some water, sir, because I don't drink that liquor. I'll definitely rock this fit. Next, we have my favorite fit from his Guess catalog. The cream with the tan accents on the collar and wrist paired with the plain maroon shirt underneath. It's just doing something I can't explain. That'll make you thrive. Okay, I'ma chill for real. I'ma chill. But this is my favorite. Then we have the I'm out with the boss, but I'm still swagging maroon denim paired with a cream button down with a maroon pattern underneath. Last, he's rocking the peanut butter no jelly denim with wood orange accents on the pockets, collar, and wrist. They did their thing with this pack as well. I wonder why they went Guess and not Levi. Either way, I like it. I'll rate this pack a 10. Now Ana Flores, the final girl. The final victim fits they shared. I don't know what store she got these from. Maybe Rainbow. But I'm not a fan, chuh. First up, she has the brown on brown with the side part in the gold head piece with the gold hoops. At first I wasn't sure if the shoulders were ripped, but they're not. This is the design of the shirt. I think my issue with the shirt is that it's too bulky on her. I'm all for the cultural look, but please in the comments let me know if I'm being disrespectful by wanting the shirt to fit on her better. Cause not knowing much about the culture's attire, I could be making a horrible observation for real. And if that's the case, let me know. Next we have the light blue with the brown accents over the chest and on the collar. After that, the next rainbow fit has a green floral button down with blue accents on the sleeves and collar and also underneath the button, paired with some pink pants. Next, she's rocking a red blouse with brown accents on the chest and collar, paired with black pants. I'm loving the color and combo on this one. This next one is probably my favorite from the rainbow collection. This yellow floral shirt with no brown accents paired with the hot pink pants is perfect. It put the one before to shame. I'd wear this one. Next, she has on her ashy blue top hat floral print with brown accents on the chest and collar, paired with some corduroy blue pants. I'm loving the corduroy pants. I ain't gonna lie. Last, she's rocking a black blouse with floral print and some peanut butter no jelly pants. I also forgot to mention her gold bracelets. I rate this pack a 6 because I don't know. And last, we have the bloody family pack coming. I feel like if I play family, it would only make sense for me to come in the match with this drip. I mean, come in the match dripping and stained with blood. The amount of blood on each family member makes a lot of sense if you take a closer look. Sissy doesn't have too much blood, but the way she goes for kills after sneaking a bit, you can tell it definitely splattered on her, even though she tried to jump back to avoid getting too much on her American Eagle dress. The cook got hella blood on him from helping either drag or carry the body to the basement or table or inside the house. So his whole fit from Express gonna be staying real bad. Leatherface ain't got no choice but to get bloodied up because he's killing, carrying, and chopping them up for that award-winning chili the town loves so much. Them nasty bastards. Johnny having blood on his hands makes so much sense because after killing his victim from close range as they try to plead for their life while looking in his eyes as they fall to the ground, he smiles and plays in their blood a bit. But just with his hands, can't get too much blood on his Hollister tank. He got a few hot dates lined up. And if you look closely, there's a handprint. Blaze Hiker doesn't have too much blood on him because he getting beat the fuck up if he try to do anything without getting the victims caught in the trap. You can tell he being scraps with the victims by the holes in his shirt. Overall, I'm excited for these packs and can't wait for the release date. I will post the date as soon as I get the information for y'all. If you haven't already, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on that bell. Until next time, peace.